and welcome back to my channel. If you are new here, I am cherielisabeth. I post videos every Tuesday and Friday, usually about Disney. I have vlogs, I have hauls, I have trip planning, all kinds of stuff, so I'd love for you to subscribe. Today I have a Disney haul. We got back from Walt Disney World just about a week ago. I have this pile of stuff sitting here. I've been itching to film this video. I'm so excited to share with you what we got. I didn't think we got that much stuff, but as it's sitting here, we kind of did. To be fair, we all got gift cards for Christmas, and so we used a lot of those gift cards, and I did, one of the bigger items I did receive as a gift. So let's jump right in. The first item was actually a gift, and it is this bag right here. It is a Disney Shop Harvey's bag. We went on this trip with my dad and my stepmom, and they surprised me with this bag. It is beautiful. It has a nice blue background, and then it has Mickey and Minnie, and they're kissing and hugging and laughing. It's really cute with the red handles. If you're not familiar with Harvey's bags, they are made out of seatbelts. So this bag is a little bit heavy. I don't know if I'll use it as a parks bag. I did take it into the parks one day as a half day bag, and it worked out great. It has this really cute Minnie and Mickey keychain and the little official Disney Shop Harvey's tag on it. I think this bag did come from Disneyland. I did not see it in the parks at Walt Disney World, and my dad and stepmom live in California and go to Disneyland often, so that's where I think that they got this bag. But it is awesome. I'm really happy with it, and in fact I carried it home on the plane and it worked out really well, so I think that this is definitely something that's gonna get a lot of use both in the parks and just around town. Next, I'll show you the jewelry that I got. I collect these Alex and Ani bracelets. I have done a video on my Alex and Ani collection. I only picked up one on this trip. There is another one that I want, and there's actually a few more that are just being released. So I will be adding more to my collection very soon, but this is what I got. I don't know how this one wasn't in my collection before, but it is the Epcot. It kind of completes my Walt Disney World Alex and Ani bracelet collection, because I have Cinderella's Castle, the Animal Kingdom tree, and now Epcot. They do not have one for Hollywood Studios, which is kind of a bummer. I mean, they have like Toy Story ones and, you know, different themed ones, but they don't have one that like represents Hollywood Studios, so they should make that one. But I picked that up. And then I got a new Pandora bracelet and two charms. I've taken off my other charms just to make it easier. So I got a castle bangle. It has the castle on it, and then it says, "Where dreams come true." It is not gonna focus on my camera, so I'm gonna go ahead and insert pictures of the items. This castle bangle has been on my list for a while. I couldn't find it online, and I believe it's a park exclusive because it does say Disney Parks on the clasp. So this was something that I went in knowing that I was gonna get. The next thing I got was this 2019 charm with the castle on it. It's a pretty nondescript castle. I think the castle is just supposed to represent any of the castles at any of the Disney parks. But it's pink, it says 2019, it has some fireworks on it, and I thought it was cute, especially because we went to Disney World right after the new year. I think we got there on the 3rd of January. And the next charm is Sorcerer Mickey. It's Sorcerer Mickey's hat with the little ears, and it is a dangle charm. I'm a huge fan of Sorcerer Mickey, so when I saw this, I knew I had to have it, but I thought those were a nice addition to my Pandora collection, and I think I'm gonna film a Disney Pandora collection video very soon. Next is clothing. I got this sweatshirt, and it's kind of that, I think it's called soft spun. It's really, really thin and really, really soft. I got it oversized, and I've actually worn it a couple times already with leggings, and it's super comfy, cozy, and super cute, and it says Mickey Mouse. It says the original Mickey Mouse, 1928. Authentic and original. And it has a little tag here on the bottom that says Walt Disney World, and it's nice because it's a hoodie that has pockets, but it's like a tunic length, so it's nice and long. So it's really cute because it covers my butt with leggings. I like that it's a little bit thinner because I can wear it in the parks in kind of those transitional months where it's warm during the day, but a little bit cooler at night. This next item is actually for my husband, and it is like a Hawaiian shirt, I guess we'll call it. And he is not really one to wear like big Mickeys on his clothing. So let me show you the print up close. So you can see that the Mickeys are on there. They're very, very subtle. I think that this is a really fun shirt for him to wear in the parks when we are on vacation. It's nice and thin. It actually, I washed it and I haven't ironed it, and it doesn't really look like it needs ironing. So that's always a plus when you're traveling, but I'm glad that he treated himself and got himself something. Next is a little outfit that my son got. He got this shirt right here. It is a Mickey Mouse Club shirt. Super cute, super simple, something that he can wear throughout the summer in the parks and at home. And then he got these cute little basketball shorts. He has started playing tennis, so we thought these were cute. They have the Mickeys going down the side, and then they have this little thing that says the one and only, and they are like that wicking, the wicking fabric, so we thought that they would keep him just dry when he gets sweaty and whatever in his tennis classes. Next, I got a hat. I don't love wearing ears all the time. They do give me a headache, and I also like the protection from the sun, especially when on those really hot and sunny days. I had my eye on this hat for a while, and on our first day there, we were at the boardwalk and I saw it, so I bought it, and you're gonna see it in the vlogs. I love it. It's pink and it just has the little Mickey bar on the top. And I washed it because it was really gross because I wore it on a day and it was pouring rain and it just got gross. I think it's super cute and it's something that I will be wearing in the parks and at home when I'm running around. Next are these guys. And if you go back to see the last video I posted, you will know that I am doing a giveaway for these potion purple ears. I will link that video up above in the description box below, and you can enter to win these purple potion ears. Moving on, we got a popcorn bucket. This is Woody's Roundup Toy Story Land. We got this popcorn bucket at Hollywood Studios. I think in the rest of the parks, they were selling, of course, like the specialty buckets, but they were selling the Christmas one. We really did not need another popcorn bucket. We have quite a few of them, but I thought that because it's Toy Story Land, I thought it'd be nice to commemorate that. We use these popcorn buckets a lot. We eat a lot of popcorn in our house, and we have enough of them that when I make popcorn, each of us get our own bucket to have our popcorn out of at home. Next is a mug. Now, this is not like a refillable mug that you can get like at the resorts to refill. This is like a one-time use mug. I got it at a little stand out in front, like almost in front of like Pecos Bills, and it is Snow White and the Seven Dwarves. It says, "Happy Holidays." I thought that it was really cute. It was pretty cheap. I didn't get anything to drink in it because I actually had bought a drink somewhere else and then I saw this, but I think it was like $5. Like I said though, it's not, doesn't have the RFID thing in there, so this was not like refillable at the resorts, but I wanted it because it's Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs, and I love to take, when I have to take my coffee to go, I love having them in these because the lid is just nice and tight. Next are plushies. I'm not a huge plushie fan myself. I don't like stuffed animals around, but we did get two this time. My husband got me this guy. It's Sorcerer Mickey, and you know I love him, and it's a cute little size. He's actually gonna sit back here on my bookcase, so you will be seeing him often. I thought it was a really, really sweet gesture, and I think he's just adorable. And of course we got Br'er Rabbit. My son wanted him last year, and we just didn't have enough room in our suitcase, and when we went on Splash Mountain, as we were exiting, my son saw it, and of course he had to have it. He's really cute. I actually washed him. I have to iron him or steam him. My son took him on the plane and his whole face just got really dirty. So I washed him before my son could sleep with him, but he is super cute and just a nice little toy for my son. We got this guy. I love these straws. We got one at Halloween that had the Headless Horseman. I found this at Animal Kingdom, and this little gingerbread person is removable, but I thought it was just really cute, something that we will have out at Christmas, and I might remove that and do something with it, but got that. We were able to score some Passholder magnets. They officially, I think, stopped giving them out like right at Christmas, but we did some sleuthing and asked some people, and we all got them. So I got three of them. Here's two of them. One will go up in my office. I don't put them on the cars because they will be stolen, but I have them on our garage door. It's metal, the one that, not our like garage door outside, but the door that goes from the garage into the house is metal, and so I have them all, we have a bunch of them. I have them all stuck to there, so it's just nice every time we come in the house, we get to remember that we're pass holders. And then I have some buttons. Being a DVC member, Disney Vacation Club member, you get certain perks and stuff, and one of them is there is a Disney Vacation Club lounge at Epcot, like right above Journey to Imagination. And we went up there, and they have like video games, iPads, you can charge your phone. They have sodas, snacks, all kinds of stuff. And so we got these buttons. It just says that we are Disney Vacation Club members. This is something new. I'd never seen them before. It's kind of fun. At Disney Springs, we did like the Trail of Trees, I think it's called. Just a small portion of it. It was actually where we entered into Disney Springs. We caught it. We got dropped off. And so they gave us these Stitches Holiday Gift Hunt. It was kind of cute. My son did Jedi training at Hollywood Studios and was given this button. And then like two random things. We did the Void at Disney Springs, which was amazing. They have them all over the country, and we did the Wreck-It Ralph one. My husband had done the like Star Wars Jedi one before. We did the Wreck-It Ralph one. It was so much fun. I highly recommend it. It'll be in our vlogs. But they gave us like this little card. That was my avatar. And I just thought it was kind of cool. I'm gonna put it up on my billboard. And we were suckers and we bought the picture. Okay, my memory card was full. So we did the Void. We bought the picture. I'll go ahead and insert it here. The Void, all about it, will be in our vlog, which will be coming up soon. It'll probably be a few weeks from now because it was later in our trip. But if you haven't done it, I highly, highly recommend it. Next, we did the Frozen Ever After dessert party, and we got these glasses. They're pretty cool. We all saved them because when you look through them, the lights look like snowflakes, and the fireworks kind of have like a snowflake effect to it. We actually got some of it on camera, so that will be coming up in a vlog very soon because that was on like our first full day there. If you've made it this far, good for you. Next are all toys. So if you don't have kids and aren't interested, you can go ahead and stop watching now. But some of this stuff is actually pretty cool. So we got the Pixar ball. It was $5.99. Thought that was fun. We got this guy. It is Buzz Lightyear, and he actually, like, when you pull him back, he like takes off on his own. Just a fun little toy, keeps my son busy. It was $9.99. And then we got an ornament. My son wanted this for his Christmas tree. He has just a little tiny Christmas tree in his room that he has ornaments on. It was $21.99. As I'm looking at this, I realize that I got an ornament too, and mine was a hand-painted ornament. They're limited edition, and I get one every time we go. They are found in the Germany pavilion in the Christmas shop there, and this one had Mickey and Minnie on it. And as soon as we got home, our tree was still up. I put it on the tree came down, and the ornament got packed away in the pile of ornaments. So I have no idea where it is, but trust me, it was super cute. My son got this guy, just a little Mickey. He's really cute. His hands move, his arms move. His shirt says 2019. We got binoculars. These we got at Animal Kingdom at Dinosaur. One of the pitfalls of exiting through the gift shop when you have a toddler is they see stuff that they want. These are really, really cute, and they'll be kind of fun in the summer to look. We have a lot of birds in our backyard, so it'll be kind of fun to see the birds in the trees. Then he got this. This was actually a little bit of pixie dust. We went on Pirates of the Caribbean. My son has wanted one of these. I didn't buy it for him. He had gotten like two toys that day already. It was the very end of the night. And he said that he wanted it, and he was actually playing with it with a cast member. And I had walked outside because the fireworks had started. My husband was inside with him, and the cast member asked my husband if it was okay if she gave it to him. So thank you to that sweet cast member. It really made his day, and now we have a hook. Next is totally random. We got the space shuttle, like the booster. a couple of astronauts, and like this launch thing. We got this as we exited Mission Space. Mission to Space? Mission to Mars. Mission to Space. Mission Space. Mission Space. My son really likes like space and space shuttles and that kind of stuff, so he saw that and he got it. Okay, almost done. Next is this, which I'm not gonna lie, like I kind of love. My son saw this the last time we were at Disney World and didn't get it, and it is like a replica of Slinky Dog Dash. And it has like the little car. It's so cute. How cute is that? I might actually steal this and put it back here on my shelf. But you just kind of put Slinky in there and then you hit go. Let's see if I can do this. And he shoots out. And when he's on the ground, he actually goes pretty far. Just the detail on this is amazing. It actually, like the ride actually has these like spinny things. So that's really fun. I kind of love that. Finally, we got this guy, Spider-Man. Which, this is pretty funny because if you know, Walt Disney World does not like have the rights to the Marvel characters at Walt Disney World because Universal does or something like that. So you don't really see Marvel characters at Walt Disney World that you see in the other parts like Disneyland or over in Paris. At the airport, they have a Universal Studios store like right next to the big Disney store. So when we arrived, we took pictures at the Disney store and then went to the bathroom and then we went by the Universal store and my son had to go in there and he wanted this little guy and he spins. He has like the little spider web and it spins. It lights up, which is adorable. And I was like, no, no, no. We haven't even gotten to the parks yet. Well, when we got back to the airport to go home, he remembered. And so I went ahead and bought it for him, which is kind of fun. We have a Buzz Lightyear from our last trip that does something similar, and he just likes to play with it. It is kind of fun. Oh my goodness, so that is what we got on the trip. If you made it this far in this video, bravo. I know that was long. We did get a lot of stuff, a lot of toys, I feel like. So thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. I would love for you to subscribe if you have not already. I post videos every Tuesday and Friday. Don't forget to enter the giveaway for the Potion Purple Ears. You must enter by Monday, January 28th, so you still have plenty of time to watch the video and enter to win those ears. Thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you next time. Bye!